Karen's birthdays. It's time for Karen's birthday. Karen's birthday. Karen's birthdays. It's time for Karen's birthday. Karen's birthday. Karen's birthdays. It's time for Karen's birthday. Karen's birthday. Karen's birthdays. It's time for Karen's birthday. Karen's birthday. Karen's birthday.
The best way we know how to wrap up the show with Karen's celebration of the birthdays of those who make the movies. Take it away.
It's very exciting.
All right. Pressure to bring this show home. It's some lively talk.
I know. Let's start off our week of birthdays by wishing a very happy birthday to the one and only Michael J. Fox.
Hey!
He turns 54, but can play anywhere from Marty McFly to Marty McFly's great-great-grandfather.
He's rangy.
He's very rangy. I think everybody likes Michael J. Fox, and that's probably because he's from Canada. And when he pursued acting, he added the J to his name as an homage to what actor?
Faults. I don't think that's the story.
Oh, what do you think it is? It's to Eric Stoltz. No.
No trick question here.
What actor did he homage to add the J?
Jack Nicholson.
No.
Jack Nicholas the golfer?
No.
J-A-Y.
Michael J. Pollard.
J-A-Y.
Who?
Michael J. Pollard.
Oh.
What?
The story I had heard.
Yes, tell us your story.
Is that his middle name was Alan, Michael Alan Fox, and he wanted to go with Michael A. Fox, and he thought it sounded stupid, so he changed it to J. Michael J.
It's
Fox.
It's actually both of those stories.
What?
Well, but he didn't want to be Michael
A.
Fox.
You're both right. Hey,
Michael J. Pollard from Little Foss and Big Halsey.
That story has nothing to do with her question.
Oh,
it's right. Yeah. But.
All right. Now we all know.
Truthful story.
All right. You want to get into the details, Paul?
We all know Fox is playing Alex P. Keaton and Family Ties and his involvement in that had P. Keaton. It had his share of miracles by being involved. First, Fox got his job after Matthew Broderick turned it down to pursue movies.
What?
Second, it was on Family Ties that he met his wife, Tracy Pollan.
Yes.
And the biggest miracle was making a young male conservative entertaining for 7 seasons.
I think the bigger miracle is that of the girlfriends, Courtney Cox and Tracy Pollan, he married Tracy Pollan.
Yeah, and which one's
Courtney
less crazy?
Cox must be boring.
Yeah, but Courtney's hot.
Oh, Lord. Okay, he continues working currently on CBS as The Good Wife, despite struggling with Parkinson's disease since 2001, when it forced him to leave ABC's Spin City. And somebody in here appeared on Spin City.
What? Well,
I know it wasn't me.
It wasn't me.
I believe
in the Charlie Sheen era.
It was the Charlie Sheen era.
And was he interesting?
Yeah, you know what? He was perfectly fine. You know, when you do, you're just doing your thing and you're not, but yeah, he was fine.
He wasn't winning.
I don't think he was nuts. I think he was all right. I think he was fine.
I'm glad you got out of that unscathed. Fox was
good to know.
I have his baby, but other than
No, I don't.
He just
one
gave
day
it
I'll
to
tell
me.
Him.
Yeah. Was that a good choice for Matthew Broderick?
Oh, yeah.
He had just done War Games, I think.
I'm thinking of the time,
82. He must have shot that in 81.
Yeah.
Probably said,
all right,
stick
here, Adam, this is up your alley. Next up, let's wish a very happy birthday to Jason Mewes.
Jason is snooched to the nooch.
He turns 41, but he can play anywhere from co-star in a Kevin Smith movie to co-star in a Kevin Smith movie.
When do they start charging for the bus?
You can't fault a guy for knowing where his bread is buttered, but just for fun, any one of you, if you can name another movie that Mewes has appeared in that is not a Kevin Smith movie, and there are 81 of them on this piece of paper. Anybody have one movie?
Jurassic Park 2.
Close.
3.
No.
Oh, well, Jay and Silent Bob make an appearance in Scream 4.
No, but you're close.
Oh, you are close.
Can you guess
Independence Day?
Absolutely. You're very close with Scream. Not the first one.
They make an appearance
in... It's Scream 3.
It is Scream 3.
Oh, 3. Okay.
Also, maybe Pauly Shore's Dead. Anybody hear of that? Or Vulgar? No.
Vulgar, that's
Beast,
Feast? One of the
horror movie.
Big fan, independent movie. Vigilante Diaries, Yoga Hosers.
Yoga Hosers, well, that's an upcoming Kevin Smith. Did it take that off the list?
Oh, that's Kevin Smith.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. All right.
Also, Zach and Mary Make a Porno. That's also Kevin Smith. Take that off the list.
Yeah, that's not on the list.
Here's a Harvey Weinstein, because I know that we all like Harvey Weinstein so much. So during the making of Chasing Amy and Dogma, it was learned that Mew's mother contracted HIV virus. When Jason attended the AIDS benefit hosted by Weinstein, he promised Weinstein promised Mewes that he would get Mewes' mother the best doctors in New York, a promise that he actually kept. Sadly, the disease is so brutal that she passed away in 2000. But I don't want to go out on bad news. So not only happy birthday to Jason Mewes, but congratulations on him becoming a father for the first time 2 months ago with he and his wife, Jordan Monsado. They gave birth to Logan Lee Mewes.
My only one surprised that that's the first time that's happened.
I know.
He made it all the way to 41 with that?
Yeah.
Slipping one past the goalie?
Yes. All right. Yes.
And up next up, let's wish a very happy birthday to Peter Dinklage. Who turns 46?
Dinklage. That is the greatest name for a short person. Dinklage.
A little person actor. Get this. A little person actor who pulled off the coolest ice feat of never playing an elf, yet he appeared in the movie Elf.
Oh, he was fantastic in Elf, wasn't he?
Great.
Oh, my God. I loved Elf.
You know him in such films such as The Station Agent and X-Men Days of Future Past, and now he's skyrocketed to fame with his Emmy and Golden Globe winning role in HBO's Game of Thrones. And here's a fun fact for you,
okay,
Bart.
Good.
Are you ready?
I do need to recover from your otherwise banal
facts. Yes, banal facts. Dinklage, like the aforementioned Michael J. Fox, he is a vegetarian. So
might explain his height.
You're so dumb.
Stunted his growth.
Hey, and Michael J. Fox, too.
That's right.
Hey,
these are not tall men.
Now listen, all the beef jerky his character eats in Station Agent is tofu. And Bart, you know how much I love when celebrities sing.
Are we at that point already?
Yeah, sure.
Well, people ask me two questions about Karen.
Yes?
All the time. They say, hey, can you tell me two interesting things about
what
Karen Volpe?
Can you tell me two interesting things about Karen
Volpe?
Well,
Ruthie.
She's currently trying to clone D.B. Wong's Wong.
B.D. Wong's Wong.
B.D. Wong's Wong. So she can open a park called Jurassic Wong.
But what about Peter's Dinklage?
I was sitting on that for like 20 minutes.
That must have been uncomfortable.
It felt old. It felt old coming out.
And she loves to hear when celebrities sing.
I do. And Peter Dinklage was in a punk band called Wizzy.
Oh, awesome.
He has the scar in his neck and his face from performing on stage at CBGB, where he was whipping himself into a frenzy on stage.
He was wiping. It's hardcore punk.
Two different shows right
he
there.
Smacked
the
his
late
head.
Show is the wiping.
He smacked his head into a fan's knee, and then he grabbed a dirty bar napkin,
ouch,
dabbed his head, and went back on with the show. It was a total punk rock moment with blood everywhere, but it didn't stop him from rocking. But not going to play that for you.
Oh, no?
No, I'm going to play something else for you, a little more loungy. As we enjoy this song, Dinklage recently performed for a charity event, Red Nose Day, that comedy event. Mm. It's a duet with Coldplay, an homage to all the main characters who've died on Game of Thrones.
Wow.
Oh. Still going strong. Yeah, yeah.
He's still going strong. He has such a deep voice for such a little man.
Remember Ned Stark? He was a lot of fun, but he didn't make it past season one.
That wraps another movie showcast, everybody. Together we are the movie guys. Individually we are
Bart Callison.